Guys, it is time. Welcome to my video with the McLaren P1 on Drive Club, guys. Today we're going to be playing around with this special car, and it's special in Drive Club. Why? Well, not only do you unlock it at level 35, not only is it beautiful, it's actually got KERS and DRS capabilities in the game that are user controllable. That is like the first time I've ever seen that in a racing game before, but here we are. This is the stock design that they give you. It's kind of like the Top Gear one, which I really, really like. But I believe, to me, it must be this kind of orange. It's just, to me, after playing with this car in so many other games, I just really, really think it should be this style of orange. But the main reason for this video is because we're going to experience the car together for the first time. That is right, I've never driven this thing before. We are about to experience it for the first time together here, guys. So we're going to be on a time trial. The idea is we're going to go a lap normally, try the car, and then we shall see how we do with DRS and KERS, because I have no idea how the whole thing works. I know the buttons, and that's literally it. So here we are with the McLaren P1 straight away. Let's see how she drives stock without these extra buttons and stuff. So I am in manual. This is the first time, as I said, driving the McLaren P1. Oh my god, it is absolutely planted to the ground. Like, I know this car's built to literally be kind of like an absolute beast when it comes to being gripped to the road, but good god, I didn't think it was going to grip this much. This grips more than anything on the game. It's so responsive, yet once you actually really, really want to turn, it requires you to slow down a lot because it has a lot of, well, you could basically say resistance to you turning because of that bloody thing on the back. That big gaping thing. Yeah, that thing. Helping me stick to the road. Like, look, I didn't even slide then when I normally would, like I did coming out of there, but normally just sliding into that, you would slide like that. You know, it's really, really planted. It's probably the most planted car I've driven on this game so far. But that is the boring lap out of the way, not gonna lie. I've been waiting so long to try this. And we're gonna try it here again on our own today, guys. I said again, but I don't really mean again. We're gonna try a new car here again today, guys. We're gonna see what this does. So, straight away I see something happening. Something blue is coming up on the dashboard if I go to the rear view. Oh, we can actually see the speedometer's got a green bar next to it and a DRS section. So let's press the DRS. And that brings the wing down, which I believe must increase our speed, right? So let's do it normally, accelerate to the top of the gear with this. So there's that. And then if we go to DRS on. Okay, that is definitely more speed-oriented when we switch the mode. So let's keep it in speed-oriented mode. And let's go for a drive with that, see how we do. Oh, yeah, she is definitely more lively now. She is definitely more lively. Look at that. That is good. So that is going to give us much more speed because the wing's not in our faces trying to absolutely ruin the bloody work of driving here. So this will increase our speed, but in the corners, we're going to want to put it back on. Oh, my God. And then turn it back off. Or turn it back on, you know what I mean. Put the spoiler back into this mode when we want to accelerate again. So it's kind of, you got to keep switching yourself. That's a really, really cool addition to the game because it kind of gives you something more to do for the experts. And really, really, I've wanted to do this in a game for so long. Such an awesome idea. Thank you so much for adding this into the game, guys. But there we go. That is that sorted. What I want to do now is actually try the KERS. Now, as far as I'm aware, this works in F1 cars. And the basic idea behind KERS is that it's going to give us a boost. Pretty much like NOS in some other games. So, as you can tell, I'm very, very excited to try this. This is what I've been waiting for. To try since the beginning of the game. I really, really wanted to try this, but today is the day we're going to try this. Are you ready, guys? Because I know I bloody am. There's me stuck still from the last one. So the way this works is it builds up power through into an electric motor when I brake. But we've done a lot of braking already, so as you can see, the bar is full. we're gonna go into first gear, hold the handbrake. You can see me pressing that there. It's so, like, instant. So we're gonna press it. We're gonna get ready, and we're gonna use our KERS. I'm terrified right now, but I'm gonna love this. Oh! I'm having a crisis! Oh my god! It refilled on the new lap. Holy shit! Oh my god! Oh my god! I can't believe that. I feel like a freaking child. Jesus Christ, that was insane. I'm speechless. I want to brake more so I can get that back up again. I really want to. I'm just going to keep like accelerating and braking so I can get that back. That is insane. I want a corner here, guys, so let me just prop the KERS there. And then switch it back round so I can come out of that corner flying. Oh, and spin out. Spoiler, sort yourself. Corner cut. Of course I cut the corner, you bloody pleb. According to you. But, oh my god. I think I have found the best car in this game. This is hands down the most fun car in the game. The Hennessy Venom pure stock experience is the most fun to drive, but this thing, when you get to play around with the freaking electronic bloody crap, I don't even care. Oh my god, here we go again. Here we go. Oh my god, that whine. It's regen because we went across the line. Oh my god. Oh my god. Hennessy Venom, I'm so sorry, you've been replaced. I don't need to drive you anymore. I have got myself a McLaren P1 that drives like an absolute god, literally. Holy crap. Guys, if you've got Drive Club, get to level 35. This is easily the best car on the game. Honestly, Jesus Christ. Let's go again. Oh, you can hear the whine even from the rear view there. Absolutely brilliant. Thank you ever so much for joining us for this video, guys. If you did enjoy it, please let me know. If you've driven the McLaren P1 yourself, did you get the same reaction I did? Because good God, there's got to be someone out there. That was absolutely amazing. Thank you ever so much for joining us for this video, guys. As I said, make sure to like if you did enjoy and you want to see anything else. Let me know down in those comment sections. But for now, I will leave you with one last hurrah. Peace.